Hello everyone. As you can see, I'm using the Kintsugi tray mold again. And as you probably know, this mold is from Mold and Shapes, and all the information of this mold is in the description box. And if you are interested in this mold or in any other of their molds, please use the promo code PT5 when ordering, so you get 5% discount. Anyway, I mixed my resin at the B20 resin from DuPont. I also link a contact in my description box. And I mixed my resin with the sun boreal flakes. And these are a little bit pinkish, and they have a shimmer of greenish, goldenish. And yeah. As you can maybe suggest, and also from my title, I am trying to make a fantasy kintsugi. So I just went with my imagination and imagination, not imagination. I say this always in a German way. And I'm just pouring into each sector, and I'm hoping to get really nice effects. I'm really in love with the kintsugi molds, and I hope it doesn't get too boring, but I think they give a lot of opportunities to make different designs and also to combine different techniques in one mold, and I really, really adore this. So now I'm mixing a little bit resin with the cotton candy. This is a mica from Petra Jungblut. I also link Petra into my description box. She has awesome micas, and this cotton candy is a wonderful color. As you can see, it has a really nice shine, and it's a very delicate color as well. It has a sort of little pearl effect, and I just adore it. So I've chosen this section for my cotton candy. I try to pour rather thin, so I have no overflowing, but it's not always possible because the lines for the kintsugi, they are maybe, I don't know, 1.5 millimeters, maybe 2 millimeters thick, so you really have to be careful. And yeah, my second section is the cotton candy. So I was really going for a sort of girly design, and I had the idea when I was at the sea. I was one day at the sea, and when we came back in the evening, it was already round about 9 or 10 o'clock. I decided to start pouring this. Crazy me. But when I have something in my mind, I just need to do it. Otherwise, it's gone. So there I mix my resin with the white. It's the pigment paste from DuPont. It's only a little bit on my stick, so not much. And what I forgot to tell you, I already put crystal in layers in the upper two sections, and I brushed them with the Cobra Color Shift Pearl from DuPont. And now on top of the crystals, I am pouring the white. Yeah, and as I said, you know, as I was speaking earlier, now I'm having my overflow, so I need to get this sorted, but it's not so easy. So I took a little bit off very carefully. Because I just wanted to have rather clear sections, and not that they are blending with each other, so this is quite challenging sometimes, because then you put a little bit too much into your mold, but there you go. You can always fix it. Like I said, I hope you're not too bored that I'm using the Kintsugi tray mold again. But as I said, there are so many options, so many different techniques. And, you know, I heard an artist saying, you know, that some people are always using the same things. And I think this is not fair saying this in generally, because you know, some artists, they are just, you know, they don't make money with their art. They're just doing it, and you cannot always afford, like some of the big artists on YouTube, to do very spectacular things. So you need to really do with what you have, and it's just enjoyable showing people, you know, what you do, and giving people ideas. And this is what I, when I heard it today, I didn't like it. But anyway, it's like it is. But I hope you understand what I mean. I mean, we all try to show things where we think we can help you. And what we all like. Of course, everyone is different. Everyone has different tastes. But I just needed to say this. So anyway, back to my video. In my center now, I put just clear. Yeah, torching my bubbles a little bit. And now I'm taking the rest of my white pigment paste. And I'm drawing with my cup. It's the first time I'm just using the cup for petals. So I have no idea how this is gonna be. And this is my cotton candy. I just go around. And then again, a little bit of the white. And I'm hoping that I don't get any blobs, because it's much thicker pouring with a cup than using the stick or even the piping bag. And yeah, we will see. And there I give it a little swirl towards the center, but I think it didn't make any sense. But anyway, and up there I'm only drawing one petal. Well, it's a fantasy tray mold, not fantasy tray mold, it's a fantasy pour in the Kintsugi mold. So yeah, just do how you feel like. Yeah, I'm torching a little bit the bubbles again. And yeah, then I thought I still have some glitter, but I already popped something on top, but it was still okay. So I mixed it and I just made a thin line of the glitter in between, just to a little bit of interest. So now I'm taking the rest of my resin, and I have the crystal white or white crystal mica from Petra Jungblut, and I'm pouring this in the other two. And now I'm a little bit struggling. I should have mixed a little bit more resin, because now I have to really thinly spread this out. But when you do this with your little wooden stick, then it should be all right. So I'm just doing it. Actually, I was really tired, you know, when I did this, but I just needed to do this. I had the whole day sun, and yeah, the sun and the sea make you really tired. From where we live, it's maybe 1.5, 2 hours driving till we are at the Belgium or the Dutch coast. But yeah, we went to the Dutch coast and it's really beautiful there. So, hi to all the Dutch people who are watching this, and of course, also to all your other people. So, anyway, let's have a look. Yeah, it's my overflow again. But I really like this. I like the colors. And this is now the next day, next morning, so 12 hours later. And I'm mixing my colors. I mixed again the B20 resin. I like this resin a lot, and because there are almost no bubbles, it's crystal clear, and I really, really like it. So, there I use the Cobra Color Shift Tint. Just a little bit and mix it into my resin. This gives it a nice sparkle. Then I'm mixing the Pearl White from Colourberry. Just to get a nice shade. I didn't mix my colors too opaque. I wanted them to be a little bit see-through. So this is again the Cotton Candy from Petra Jungblut. I'm already very, very curious if this really works out beautiful. This is the Quicksilver from Petra Jungblut. Oh no, it's a sparkling spark. Sorry, it's not the Quicksilver. It's the Twinkle Silver, Sparkling Silver. Yeah, it's this one. And I mixed. Yeah, I was thinking what. Fourth color, so I went into my box and I got the Sahara Crystal Gold, also from Petra, because it's a very soft gold, in fact, and I like the color a lot. So I thought, why not? First I was intending just to pour plain gray, but then I thought, no, just try to go with different colors. So first, all my cotton candy. Give it a quick torch. And this is, now I have to think. That was a pearl white. And the silver. No, this is a pearl white before. Sorry, was the Cobra color shift. I'm sorry. This is a pearl white. You always have to remember what you've done. Now there's the gold. Yeah, and I need to fill up my torch again. And the silver again. The pearl white. The gold. Again, the white, it's now the rest. And some silver. Torching again, and you can see already outside how nicely the colors are blending. And now I'm gonna go with a little bit of clear also around. And just another round. And sometimes I wished, you know, the resin would just stay as you pour. I like this. But of course I wanted it to blend so it will look hopefully nice on the other side. Yeah. Okay, this is another 12 hours later and unmolding. Look how nicely it blended. And it goes easily out of the mold, as you can see. And look at this. I really like it. Very, very happy. It's like, yeah, it's like you really glue every section with each other. So I'm very happy. I'm also happy that the these flakes are not like litter, just you know, right on the bottom. They really look like floating, and this is what I like. And now I'm showing you what I use for my lining. I use the Extreme Sheen, the silver from Deco Art, and I put this into this needle squeeze bottle. And I'm just going along the lines. I'm not showing you the whole tray, but you can see. Yeah, and that's almost done with my video. What I need to say, if you wonder that the edges where the crystals are not so... yeah, I didn't make a top layer yet because there's high humidity in Belgium. And I didn't want to take the risk that that the top layer is not working, but the crystal effect is amazing. Once this is done, I will show you the final result. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.